Hello, this is Dr. Heidi Horsley, the Executive Director for the Open to Hope Foundation, and I'm here today with Brianne Overton. Brianne, tell us a little bit about what you do.
Sure. I am a grief counselor in the St. Louis metropolitan area. I work with kids and teens, and I work with kids from, you know, in marginalized populations, underrepresented populations. And so it's not just that they're coming to the center and I'm working with them, but I'm actually out in the community doing community outreach. I partner with different housing communities and the different after-school programs and summer programs that they have. So to the kids and I meet them where they are. I call myself a traveling counselor. And so you give me a location. So whether it's your school, whether it's a preschool, daycare, after school program, high school, middle school, community center, a lot of my clients don't have the access or the means to travel to me. Mm-hmm. I can travel to them.
From a cultural perspective, what do you see as differences in the way that people grieve based on culture?
Sure. So culture, you take that into account when you're working with people that are grieving. So I identify as a Black female, but I cannot say that all Black females grieve the same way. And so it's really learning about, so if I go into someone's home, I'm learning a lot about them visually. So what I see, what I sense, I'm using all of my senses to kind of just take in their environment and helping them where they are and trying to meet their needs based on what they need and not based on what I think that they need.
Do you though see any themes and patterns in the Black culture that are used to deal with loss?
Definitely. So, you know, a lot of I see just in St. Louis, we've had a lot of media over the last, you know, 6 months, 8 months. And so I've had people ask me, why do people put pictures and names on T-shirts? Well, that's an outward expression of our grief. So we are showing you, or these T-shirts are showing you that this is a person that we've lost. This is a person that has died. And this is our tribute to them. And this is how we, you know, we grieve together and we pull everyone in, and you know, it's a community, a grieving community, and it's not just one person that is grieving, but we're all grieving and we're connected through these T-shirts and we're connected to each other globally, really.
I like that, and I would think that faith would be a big part of healing also.
Definitely. You have to take faith into consideration. And not everyone has the same faith or the same faith systems. And so it's educating as a clinician, educating yourself on what the faith system is for each of the families that you're working with or each of the individuals that you're working with, and pulling that in and not steering clear of it, because that's a huge part of how people grieve.
So, Brianne, when you work with these disenfranchised communities and these kids, what are the give me a few things that help them to find hope again after a loss.
Sure. So really it's just, you know, sitting with someone, listening to their needs and trying to help them, trying to meet them where they are. Some of those things would be, you know, like there's always lots of food around. So we, you know, we bond together over food, right? talking, it's storytelling. It's remembering the person that died, remembering them, how they were before they died. And not so much, you know, how they died, like if they were killed or, you know, if it was death by suicide or if it was death by a violent accident or anything like that. But it's just, you know, remembering that person and remembering who that person was.
And this is Dr. Heidi Horsley for the Open to Hope Foundation.